Hello dear students, welcome back to Learn Physics. In today's video, we are going to discuss about some of the important formulas from electromagnetic induction. First one is magnetic flux. How can we find out magnetic flux? B dot A. B dot A, we can represent it as BA cos theta. Theta is the angle between A and B. Next is induced EMF. EMF equals minus N into d phi by dt. Next is EMF induced in the moving conductor is E equals BLV. Magnetic flux phi equals LI. Magnetic flux phi equals LI. L is the coefficient of self-induction. And next is E equals minus L into di by dt. So this formula and all, that is E equals minus N into d phi by dt. And while substituting phi as Li, we can take L outside, minus L into di by dt. If there are N turns are there for the coil, minus L N into di by dt, like that we will get. So these are from Faraday's electromagnetic induction. Next is self-inductance of a solenoid. Self-inductance we can find out by mu 0 mu r into n square a divided by l. Mutual inductance, that is equal to minus m into di by dt. Next is mutual inductance of a solenoid coil system. Mu 0 n 1 n 2 a by l. N1 is the number of turns per meter and N2 is the number of turns in the coil. Next is energy stored in the inductance. U equals half Li square also you can take, or half phi I. That is energy stored in the inductor. Next one. Next we are representing the direction of current induced. What will be the direction of current induced? If we are considering a straight wire and coil system, a straight wire through that current is moving, then how the direction of induced current will be? So initially the current is increasing. If the current is increasing, if it is increasing, the induced current will be in the clockwise direction, and the current is decreasing, then it will be in the anti-clockwise direction. Next is self-inductive circuit. If we are considering an inductor, this is an inductor. So in the inductor, while we are switching on, that is if key is pressed, then the direction of induced current will be opposite to the direction of main current. Direction of induced current is if the switch is on. That while the switch is on, current is increasing. So induced EMF will try to reduce the current. For that, the current should be, the induced current will be always acting in the direction opposite to the main current. While we are releasing the key, while the key is released, so current is not flowing, right? So that will be the cause of this induced EMF. It will be opposing as per Lenz's law. So we can write it as the induced current will be in the direction of main current if key is released. Next one, magnetic coil system. While we are considering a magnetic coil system, see a man observing the current from here, and if north pole is approaching the coil, the system will try to, while it is approaching, it will try to repel it. Because the approaching case at that time, because of that change only, induced EMF is producing. So it will try to repel. Repelling means it will be, south pole should be produced over there. So it is in the anti-clockwise direction. Now, it is north pole is receding the coil, then it will be moving in the clockwise direction. So that both the directions you need to understand there clearly. Okay, if a coil is there and if north pole is coming towards the coil, suppose a north pole is coming towards the coil, so what will happen? The system will try to repel this north pole. For repulsion, here we require a north pole. If a north pole is here how the current will be, the induced current will be in the anti-clockwise direction. Then only north pole will be forming. Next is, so next, depending on this, we are doing some of the MCQs based on that. First one, whenever the flux linked with the circuit changes, there is an induced EMF in the circuit. This EMF in the circuit lasts for a long, for a very short duration, for a long duration, forever, as long as the magnetic flux in the circuit changes. As long as the magnetic flux linked with the circuit changes, an EMF will be inducing in the circuit. So the answer is D. As long as the magnetic flux in the circuit changes. Next one. The area of a square shaped coil is 10 to the power minus 2 meter square. Its plane is perpendicular to the magnetic field of strength 10 to the power minus 3 tesla. The magnetic flux linked with the coil. Flux equals, flux phi equals B dot A. That is BA cos theta. Right? So area of a square coiled area is 10 to the power minus 2 meter square. Its plane is perpendicular to the magnetic field strength. So what will be the angle between B and A? The direction of A will be always perpendicular to the plane. So plane is perpendicular to the magnetic field and the direction of area will also be perpendicular. So what will be the angle between them? Theta will be equal to 0. So here we can cos 0 as 1. So here phi equals B into A. So 10 to the power minus 3 into 10 to the power minus 2. The answer is 10 to the power minus 5. See here. 10 to the power minus 5 Weber. Third one. An area of 0.5 meter square shown in figure is situated in a uniform magnetic field B equals 4 Weber per meter square and its normal makes an angle of 60 degree with the field. The magnetic flux passing through the area A would be equal to. So here also we need to find out the magnetic flux. So B is moving like this, area is acting like this, the angle between them given as 60 degree. So phi will be equal to BA cos 60. B is 4, area is 0.5, cos 60 is 1 by 2. So here we will be getting it as 1 Weber. The answer is 1 Weber. Next one. See here, next one is a square of side L meter lies in the XY plane in a region where the magnetic field is given by B equals B0 into 2I plus 3J plus 4K Tesla, where B0 is a constant. The magnitude of flux passing through the square is. So here square of side L meter lies in XY plane. If it is lying in XY plane, what will be the side is L. So what will be the area? Area we can represent it as L square. What will be the direction of area? Will be perpendicular to the plane. XY plane means it will be acting along Z axis. So I can represent it as K. When the magnetic field is given as B equals B0 into 2I plus 3J plus 4K Tesla, find the magnitude of flux. Flux phi equals B dot A. So only K and K we need to multiply. While we are multiplying K and K, it is here what is 4K into L square. So here we will be getting it as 4K L square because K dot K. Into B0. K dot K will be 1. All others I dot I dot 4 dot it is 0i plus 0j. So here that and all will become 0. Only K will be existing 4K L square B0. That much Weber it is. So 4K L square. So K is, sorry, this is K is the unit vector, right? K dot K will become 1. So 4 L square B0. 4L² B₀ Weber. Okay, this is the answer. Next one, a loop made of straight edges has 6 corners. Okay, 00, L00, C of LL00 and D of 0LL, like this. 6 straight edges has 6 corners. The corners are given like this. Magnetic field B equals B0 into I plus K Tesla is present in the region. The flux passing through the loop is ABCDEFA is, what will be the flux passing through that? So for that we will consider a loop made of straight edges has 6 corners. So first I'll represent in a 3-dimensional way. It has 6 corners. A loop is made. So here I am considering a loop like this. Okay. So here I get A, B, C, D. What is A? A is 0, 0. So I can represent A here. And B is L, 0, 0. So I'll represent B over here. And C is L, L, 0, 0. So I'll represent C here. D is 0L. So D is here. E is 0LL. That is 0LL. So here it is over here. Then next is, this is Z axis, this is X axis, and this is Y axis. Next is E is given. F is 0LL. 00L. This is F. This is the plane. The flux passing through it. How can we find out the flux passing through the circuit? Here, how can we represent magnetic field in the circuit? Magnetic field is given as B0 I plus K. That is magnetic field in the circuit. Okay, magnetic field is given as B0 I plus K Tesla is present in the region. The flux. Flux phi equals B dot A. So here in this, they are asking us to find out the flux passing through the loop A, B, C, D, E, F, A. So here A, B, C, D is here in this one and D, E, F, A is in this part, right? So here what will be the flux in A, B, C, D? Flux, how we will find out B dot A, that is B, both are parallel. So we can write it as B, A. B is B0 I cap plus K cap. Now, B0 into I cap plus K cap. What is A here? A will be equal to L square. L is one side is L, right? So, this side is L. So, it is L square. In which direction it will be? Since it is in XY plane, it will be along the Z axis. So, we will be getting it as B0 L square. K dash K cap dot K cap equals 1. Next is flux along the next one, that is flux which is passing through the next area, that is DEFA, that is B dot A. So B0 into I cap plus K cap into L square. This is in YZ plane, so it is acting along the area vector, will be perpendicular to that, that is along the X axis I cap. So I cap dot I cap equals 1 B0 L square. So here B0 L square, this also B0 L square. Together we can write it as 2 B0 L square Weber. So this is the final answer. Next one, an EMF is produced in a coil which is not connected to an external voltage source. This can be due to, what will be the, it will be due to the first one, the coil being a time varying magnetic field. Yes, if it is a time varying magnetic field, then only EMF will be induced in the coil, right? So that is correct. The coil moving in a time varying magnetic field, that also time varying, coil is moving. Also, we can consider magnetic flux linked with the circuit changes, so an EMF is inducing. The next one, the coil moving in a constant magnetic field, that is wrong. All of the above anyway wrong. So the answers, these two are correct. Okay, clear? So these are some of the questions which we discussed today. So hope today's video is useful for you. And if you like the channel, please don't forget to subscribe, like and share. Thank you for watching. Bye.